emails and the secret server and the passing classified documents over an unsecured server. So for him to speak out on this right now doesn't really help us. But you know, I want to say this about what happened in North Carolina, too, if I can do this just for a second. If a voter registration drive set up by the NAACP, an office building was set up and it was firebombed. You know darn well that the rhetoric would come out that it was Donald Trump involvement, that he's responsible. Absolutely. Republicans are responsible with no foundation. Well, so for that to happen on the other side, I think it's legitimate. I think it's a legitimate argument.
That was your point in this tweet that you sent out. You said in the tweet, it's incredible that our institutions of government, White House, Congress, DOJ, and big media are corrupt, and all we do is blank. You said pitchforks and torches time. What do you mean by that?
I meant the same thing that Frederick Douglass, the abolitionist, said when he said that the institution of slavery is a system of brute force and it must be fought with its own weapons. I meant the same thing when Barack Obama in 2008, July of 2008, at a fundraiser and talking about how he would deal with Republicans, he said, if they pull a knife, we'll pull a gun. I said the same thing when during the entire summer, we had to listen to Bernie Sanders talk about the need for a revolution in America and the leftist media. Fox not included, Fox News. The leftist media had no problem with that. But all of a sudden, when I talk about the corruption, and a growing number of Americans are fed up with this government, they feel it no longer belongs to them. They no longer have any control of it. We're not a constitutional republic. We are become an administrative state. The Constitution is being shredded. The rule of law doesn't matter for certain people in Washington, D.C., and people have had it. I'm suggesting the same thing the founding fathers did in the 1770s when they drew up the Declaration of Independence, which is why I always say, go back and read your Declaration of Independence.
Sure.
It's right there. Were they inciting violence? No. But what they wanted was self-rule. They wanted a government that was controlled by the people and not the bureaucrats in Washington. Yeah.
Sheriff, let me ask you this. Donald Trump's been talking about how it looks like the system is rigged against him, that the mainstream media working with the Clinton machine to talk about all the bad stuff, allegations about Donald Trump, and they're completely, for the most part, glossing over WikiLeaks. Do you see it that way?
Wholeheartedly, and so does everybody else, anybody who doesn't have their head in the sand. Look, the WikiLeaks stuff is very damaging, and the liberal mainstream media, I call it big media now because that's what they are. They're in bed. There's evidence. There are email exchanges between the Clinton campaign, the New York Times, between others that demonstrate this.
So,
MSNBC, right, it demonstrates that. So, yeah, I think Donald Trump has a very good point. This system is rigged, and when you have big media, and that's a shame. You know, they used to be the fourth estate. They used to be the government watchdog. They are now the propaganda wing of the Democrat Party.
So let's talk about what we find out. More and more people are saying this with a simmering cauldron of FBI agents that worked on the Hillary Clinton investigation that are extremely upset by the overall review and what James Comey came out with. And now we find out that the FBI is possibly was being coerced by Patrick Kennedy to change classifications on certain emails in exchange for possibly getting positions overseas. Mm-hmm. The FBI responds to this by saying the classification of the email exchange was not changed and it remains classified today, although there was never a quid pro quo. These allegations were nonetheless referred to the appropriate officials for review. Jason Chaffetz got this. He's the chairman of this. He's going to look into it. Should he?
Oh, yeah, it's very damning. And, of course, the higher-ups at the FBI. I'm not saying the entire institution of the FBI. The agents are on the up and up. But the higher-ups in that institution, they are corrupt. Of course, they're going to deny it. Look, that email that you're talking about is very damning, and it should be looked at. But the thing is, this is another example. Look at what happened with the IRS when they targeted Americans who had different political beliefs. All of our institutions of government have been infected by this corruption, and so there's no surprise here. And all they do is just they sit up there and deny it. But look, the American people are smart. I trust the American people. They're seeing right through this. This is a shame. This is a shameful period in American history.
Making it really tough. You know, will Donald Trump be able to beat this? I mean, when all the mainstream media is for Hillary Clinton, makes it a little tough.
Well, he'll be able to beat it. Going to be on Wednesday.
He'll be able to beat it if he can get his people to the polls. Look, there's a simmering undercurrent here of people who can't be captured in the polls. They've had it with this crap, too. And so, you know, we'll see on November 8th if he can get large numbers of people, including blacks to either stay home because they're disappointed with what's going on, but maybe with both parties. But if he can get a number of black voters to the polls to vote for him as well, I still think he can win this thing. Look, they don't call him the comeback kid for nothing.
There you go. All right.
Thank you, Sheriff.
And the secret server and the passing classified documents over an unsecured server. So for him to speak out on this right now, it doesn't really help us. But, you know, I want to say this about what happened in North Carolina, too, if I can do this just for a second. If a voter registration drive set up by the NAACP, an office building was set up and it was firebombed, you know darn well that the rhetoric would come out that it was Donald Trump involvement, that he's responsible.
Absolutely.
Republicans are responsible with no foundation. Well, so for that to happen on the other side, I think it's legitimate. I think it's a legitimate argument.
That was your point in this tweet that you sent out. You said in the tweet, it's incredible that our institutions of government, White House, Congress, DOJ, and big media are corrupt, and all we do is blank. You said pitchforks and torches time. What do you mean by that?
I meant the same thing that Frederick Douglass, the abolitionist, said when he said that the institution of slavery is a system of brute force and it must be fought with its own weapons. I meant the same thing when Barack Obama in 2008, July of 2008, at a fundraiser and talking about how he would deal with Republicans. He said, if they pull a knife, we'll pull a gun. I said the same thing when during the entire summer, we had to listen to Bernie Sanders talk about the need for a revolution in America and the leftist media. Fox not included, Fox News. The leftist media had no problem with that. But all of a sudden, when I talk about the corruption, and a growing number of Americans are fed up with this government, they feel it no longer belongs to them. They no longer have any control of it. We're not a constitutional republic. We are become an administrative state. The Constitution is being shredded. The rule of law doesn't matter for certain people in Washington, D.C., and people have had it. I'm suggesting the same thing the founding fathers did in the 1770s when they drew up the Declaration of Independence, which is why I always say, go back and read your Declaration of Independence.
Sure.
It's right there. Were they inciting violence? No, but what they wanted was self-rule. They wanted a government that was controlled by the people and not the bureaucrats in Washington. Yeah.
Sheriff, let me ask you this. Donald Trump's been talking about how it looks like the system is rigged against him, that the mainstream media working with the Clinton machine to talk about all the bad stuff, allegations about Donald Trump, and they're completely, for the most part, glossing over WikiLeaks. Do you see it that way?
Wholeheartedly, and so does everybody else, anybody who doesn't have their head in the sand. Look, the WikiLeaks stuff is very damaging, and the liberal mainstream media, I call it big media now because that's what they are. They're in bed. There's evidence. There are email exchanges between the Clinton campaign, the New York Times, between others that demonstrate this.
So,
MSNBC, right. It demonstrates that. So, yeah, I think Donald Trump has a very good point. This system is rigged, and when you have big media, and that's a shame. You know, they used to be the fourth estate. They used to be the government watchdog. They are now the propaganda wing of the Democrat Party.
So let's talk about what we find out. More and more people are saying this with a simmering cauldron of FBI agents that worked on the Hillary Clinton investigation that are extremely upset by the overall review and what James Comey came out with. And now we find out that the FBI is possibly was being coerced by Patrick Kennedy to change classifications on certain emails in exchange for possibly getting positions overseas. Mm. The FBI responds to this by saying the classification of the email exchange was not changed and it remains classified today, although there was never a quid pro quo. These allegations were nonetheless referred to the appropriate officials for review. Jason Chaffetz got this. He's the chairman of this. He's going to look into it. Should he?
Oh, yeah, it's very damning. And, of course, the higher-ups at the FBI. I'm not saying the entire institution of the FBI. The agents are on the up and up. But the higher-ups in that institution, they are corrupt. Of course, they're going to deny it. Look, that email that you're talking about is very damning, and it should be looked at. But the thing is, this is another example. Look at what happened with the IRS when they targeted Americans who had different political beliefs. All of our institutions of government have been infected by this corruption, and so there's no surprise here. And all they do is just they sit up there and deny it. But look, the American people are smart. I trust the American people. They're seeing right through this. This is a shame. This is a shameful period in American history.
Making it really tough. You know, will Donald Trump be able to beat this? I mean, when all the mainstream media is for Hillary Clinton. Makes it a little tough.
Well, he'll be able to beat it.
He'll be able to beat it if he can get his people to the polls. Look, there's a simmering undercurrent here of people who can't be captured in the polls. They've had it with this crap, too. And so, you know, we'll see on November 8th if he can get large numbers of people, including blacks, to either stay home because they're disappointed with what's going on, but maybe with both parties. But if he can get a number of black voters to the polls to vote for him as well, I still think he can win this thing. Look, they don't call him the comeback kid for nothing.
There you go.
All right. Thank you, Sheriff.